Hernandez. His effective healing did what? Get increased by 30%, I believe. And so now on the defense, we're seeing basically standard composition. It's going to be a 2-2-2. Toxican picking up the Tracer while Bromas will be on that Soldier 76. The tank line for Dignitas, it's going to be what? 7 on that Reinhardt and Linkster picking up that Roadhog. So if anyone tries to dive on top of that comp, he's going to be able to deal with it for the most part. And of course, rounding it out totally, it's going to be, of course, Vainless on the Ana and Evoke on that Lucio.
So we are going to be seeing Dignitas running a selfless composition here, pulling this one out. And we've seen a couple of teams trying to use this in practice, and it hasn't worked as well as what we've seen the enemy counterparts of. Obviously, the godfathers of the composition certainly have run it the best so far. But that's going to be for both teams, actually, who are both bringing it out now. Mirror compositions, again, that selfless comp from both sides and running that Soldier Tracer. And we do see Dignitas, of course, up on some high ground, at least with a Tracer. But Bromas not opting for that. And we do see now the side of Laser Kittens just rushing over to the high ground themselves, getting in position. Krim's almost taken down there, but able to feed himself back towards that window.
Yeah, Laser Kittens grabbing that high ground now. We are seeing the rest of Dignitas just backing away. They have to wait off as Toxican did get caught out there. Now, already we've almost got a tick on the point. Actually, ticks don't really quite matter. It's about percentages, right, at this point?
Yeah, it is gonna be about percentages when it comes down to it as well, because we are on that live patch, and we do see Toxican back in that window just contesting Krims, forcing him out. And Linkster actually did manage to get a pick there, and they should be sending these attackers back as Nezh actually falls there to Linkster's primary fire. And actually, we do as well see Winghaven now still on the point, trying to hold out. His barrier's getting down low. He's trying to find a kill, and that charge is actually going to open him up, and they're going to find a kill themselves. Toxican with a nice triple pulse bomb there, sending everybody back to the spawn, and they do make that defensive hold. One tick now for Dignitas at the moment.
Yeah, and so it gets rewound there. At this point, though, Dignitas look like they're in a really good spot, right? They've almost got that Earth Shatter. The whole hog's about to come out for Linkster. And Bromas is going to have that Nano Visor to work with. The only thing they're really going to be lacking in is going to be Toxican's Pulse Bomb, but it's Tracer. She's going to be able to build that up really quickly now. They don't really have to worry about the high grounds and on the side of Laserkin, so all we see is Nezh up there right now. Great pulse one coming out onto Watt7, but he will get healed up immediately, almost back to full already. Sound Barrier comes out on the Laserkins, coming out from both sides, and oh no, Watt7 unfortunately gets that shadow right into his shield, but Linkster gets that pick off onto Winghaven, and now they're pushing forward. They've got that Nano Visor. Bromas on the hunt. He will be able to take out Krems. Now they're starting to clean up on the side of Dignitas.
Very, very clean fight for Dignitas there. I mean, they were able to take Nesh's Pulse Bomb out. I mean, I don't know really what they were thinking with Nesh throwing that Pulse Bomb out. They needed to have at least some follow-up to be able to find that extra little bit of damage. You're not just going to one-shot the tank like that. There's no Discord on him or anything like that. So, I mean, they needed a little bit of follow-up. They didn't have any there. And it was basically just pretty easy for them to fall back, get the healing over to Watt7, and he just completely filled that back up. And we saw a nice turnaround with Bromas coming through with that Nano Visor. Now, Toxican here did manage to get his Pulse Bomb, and he's looking for an opportunity. Actually throws it out. Does get Krims. Krims doesn't move away from it.
And now they are on the hunt. They immediately push forward, but Laserkins are able to back out without bleeding too much there. Now they are working with a huge power spike. They've got that Nano Visor at the ready. Whole hog along with that Earth Shatter. Now the only thing really is going to be Spazzo without the Sound Barrier, as Nezh has swapped off now to that Zarya. So triple tank now coming out on the side of Laserkins as they are making their way, wrapping around a statue here, but they still have to be careful. Tactical Visor, Nano Visor coming in on the side of Laserkins. It's going to be Krems that gets that first kill onto Toxican. Everyone else on the side of Dignitas have been able to kite away and break the line of sight, though.
They do lose Linkster, though, in the process, and Winghaven getting down pretty low. Bromas going to come through with Attack Visor of his own, and he coming off that high ground. And he's actually, I don't like the fact that he jumped down there, because he's going to get eliminated very easily, although he needed to contest as the rest of his team was dying off. And Laser Kittens with the cap there, 250 on the clock as they get that capture.
Now, because Bromas did use that Tactical Visor, he does have that opportunity to swap off. He's going to go ahead and pick up the McCree instead. So interesting to actually see the McCree come out. They don't really have to deal with any backliners on the side of Dignitas here. So we'll see if possibly they're just going to try and work in conjunction with the Reinhardt and try to get that shield down. Go for that Earth Shatter. I think that's what they're looking for, is what 7 is sitting on it. Great hook comes out, but oh no, it's a hook 2.0. It gets broken.
And we do see Kib backed up a little bit there and looking for a flashbang here from Dignitas, but that's not going to be necessary as they just use the whole hog to push that shield back, push the rest of the team of Laser Kittens away as well. And that is now going to be the Sound Barrier coming out actually from Evoke, and they're going to push forward again. Nice flashbang onto the Reinhardt, and they pull out Krims's Tac Visor, not really finding too much initially as he gets pushed back, but they are going to be able to wipe this one up here. Laser Kittens with a nice re-entry through that archway are going to be able to push through, and they should just find this last kill onto Toxican, and that will happen very, very soon. But actually, Toxican coming through with a nice pick onto Windhaven. That might give his team just enough time to jump onto that point and try to contest. They could do it 5v5, actually, given the fact that the other team doesn't have a Reinhardt. Laser Kitten's going to be down a little bit, and certainly we will see him coming back quickly, but same could be said for the Tracer here, Jamerson.
Yeah, on the side of Dignitas, Toxican has now swapped off. No more Tracer. It's going to be mirrored compositions once again. Nano boosted Whole Hog coming on out from the side of Laser Kittens as they are just trying to push everyone back and push this payload forward. There's a minute left for Laser Kittens to go ahead and push this in, but now it's going to be a full 6v6 fight, and now they are down ultimates. Dignitas, they do have that Nano boost to work with. Who are they going to put it on? It's going to be onto Watt7 as they push forward. He does get put to sleep, but they've already got the kill onto Windhaven. Now Watt7 does get hooked in as he does have to actually fall because of that purple health coming out. Now Kib does get hooked in himself, but unfortunately Linkster isn't able to follow up on it quite yet. Here comes the Whole Hog coming out from Linkster, and now they're pushing forward. They do have that healing pack down there. Now it's just down to supports on the side of Dignitas, but Krems is just going to go ahead and use that Nano Visor to clean it up. With 25 seconds left, they will be able to get that second checkpoint, the first checkpoint, and Krems already pushing up towards that spawn.
Yeah, so Bromus actually wound up pulling back into that first point spawn, and with 1 HP tried to make a re-entry, but you know, Nesh didn't forget about him at all. He came through and found that quick kill, and they just wiped up the rest of Dignitas pretty easily here. They don't have a lot of time to work with through this factory phase of the map, and certainly Whatseven's going to be looking to try to slow things down a bit. But we do see the Graviton coming out there from Nesh, and we do see Dignitas falling inside of it, but it's back and forth right now as Kib already found a couple of kills, looking for another kill onto the Roadhog here, but a nice Earth Shatter here, Jamerson. But that's still not going to be enough as we do see Laser Kittens pulling through once again. Not much time, but man, are they at a good pace right now to try to close this one out.
Yeah, that was a great Earth Shatter coming out from Whatseven. Unfortunately, the timing not so great as it was just him and one other person there, and they got cleaned up pretty quickly. Landing on the three members, if they had gotten the fourth, it might have just been the wipe. Now we do have that Deadeye getting popped by Bromos just to push them back just a little bit. 45 seconds still left on the clock for Laserkins as they push forward, and they're in a great spot. They've got the Dragon Blade. Windhaven has his Earth Shatter to work with. Now it's all going to come down to really Toxican here with that Graviton Surge. But at this point, Laserkins doing a really good job of staying spread out here.
Oh, we do see the Graviton coming in. I don't really like the positioning of that, but it is going to push Nesh up and down, and that's going to make it hard for them to actually find that kill. So he's going to be able to cleanly get out of that Graviton Surge that was placed there. And despite the fact that Bromus is getting very aggressive here, they are going to be able to back these guys out just with the zoning pressure of Bromus alone and not actually from any frags that he wound up getting. Linkster coming up with a couple of kills just to clean things up, and now they need to get on the point, and I'm not too sure they're going to be able to make it.
Now there's a Graviton Surge that can come out from Nesh here. Unfortunately, he's just way too far behind. Windhaven wasn't able to get onto the point. Could have been a good fight for them as everyone would have just been on top of the payload. Unfortunately, Laserkins weren't able to get there, but switching sides. Because of the pace that was really set during the streets phase, I think Laserkins got a lot more than they were expecting here. The payload almost getting pushed all the way to the end. And so now we are going to go ahead and flip sides here as we do see 65.16 meters on the spot.
Now looking to see what we're going to be seeing from the attacking side. And, you know, we saw McCree yesterday for NA as well. Obviously, we're looking to see what kind of changes and what kind of ways we see teams adapting to this Lucio change. And one thing that I've noticed actually is teams opting for McCree in some situations, especially when they know that they're going to be fighting in close quarters often, is going for that McCree. And the reason being is that you can make a really good use out of that flashbang, given the fact that everybody wants to ball up on the opposing team if they're running those tanks. They want to stay on the Lucio, and you can get a lot of value out of a flashbang to try to not only shut down the shield, but also just get in a nice little bit of instant burst damage on everybody inside of that ball there, inside of that Lucio ring, as soon as you land that flashbang as well. So a lot of teams decide that they do want to use that, and we didn't see it to super great effect here with Bromas, but it worked a lot better, I think, last night with Train utilizing it in NA. But again, we are going to be seeing on the defensive side a triple tank strat here. Krims in the back line here with Gray up on top, taking some high ground, something that we actually didn't see on the side of Dignitas, with Bromas sitting on the point pretty consistently. The only person who really took that high ground was actually Toxicant on the Tracer, and of course he would just jump down very quickly, so it didn't really amount to much here. But we will see the Lynx around the moment. At the moment, just on this Hanzo, just going to send out a quick arrow and more than likely switch off pretty quick. Oh, he's staying on this.
Yep.
And that's with the Zarya here. Down.
Yeah, he's got Bromas on the Zarya, and of course Toxicant coming up with a huge pick, taking out Nesh with that charge, and now they are onto the point.
And they're just establishing themselves early here, and Lynx are trying to get into a position where he can deal with this soldier. And with him in that little closet there, in that window, he should be able to get a nice arrow over to him, but he's not even going to try to contest that. He's just going to go ahead and throw damage into the main line here, as we do see the soldier of Krims just pushing back into the lobby of that hotel. And what 7 actually is going to be falling. They just completely fall. They just didn't have enough damage at all, which is interesting. I mean, it really just came down to Lynxer not being able to land those shots. Kib finding that kill, that's going to be it. Dignitas forced to go back to respawn, and Lynxer giving up that high ground.
Yeah, that last team fight more than less came down to just Kib actually landing some crucial picks there with that Roadhog. And so now it's just going to get reset. Both teams just facing off over at Statue. Sound boost going to be used by Evoke. And take a look. Evoke pushing forward now. He's got to play a really aggressive style as a sound barrier comes out on the side of Dignitas here. Graviton Surge committed. Bromas did get two kills off of it. Unfortunately, Kib with that whole hog starting to clean up. Now Lynxer going to go ahead and use that Dragon Strike. Gets one kill onto Winghaven. And that's going to allow Dignitas to take this point. 2 minutes and 20 seconds remaining on the clock when it does get captured.
That fight couldn't have happened any better for what 7 there at all on the side of Dignitas as well. I mean, we saw the Sound Bear coming out and getting ready for Spazzo. He went to go through that casting animation and immediately got charged randomly as he came through the archway. And it just completely shut him down and the rest of Laser Kittens. And that allowed Dignitas to just go for that nice simple combo of that Graviton Surge into the Dragon Strike, found the eliminations that they needed to find, and now Lynx are up on top with the high ground again, looking like they're going to be pushing through the street phase here, and it's going to be what 7 versus Winghaven here to try to get a nice Earth Shatter. I expect some aggression here coming out from the Reinhardts a little bit, but maybe not before we do see the barriers going down pretty low, and that's going to be what 7 getting down dangerously low on his barrier, forced to kind of get that back up. Winghaven not wanting to try to take advantage. He doesn't know when that barrier is going to come back up here.
Yeah, now Kib has swapped it off to Genji once again here as we have entered into the streets phase, but Lynxer with the headshot on that arrow is going to take out Gray. Now it's going to be a one-for-one trade as the Shimada brothers are going to battle it out in the field here. Now we do have the sound barrier getting popped on the side of Laserkins, but Toxicant is just going to go ahead and use that whole hog to push them all back. Now we do have Bromas, he's working his way up towards that Graviton Surge, but at this point it is, like you said, it's coming down to the Reinhardt's Winghaven versus what 7 Dragon Strike coming out, but it's gonna go mostly into the ground here. Now Bromas pushing forward with that Zarya picking up two kills. They're starting to really make some headway here on the payload, and with all those staggered kills, they should be able to push up, and I don't think they're gonna have an opportunity to really try and defend here before it makes it to the second checkpoint.
And Kib actually with that Dragon Blade, ooh, somehow manages to get away from that hook, and now he gets nano boosted, looking for some Dragon Blade kills, is going to find one onto what 7. They find the next kill on Toxicant. That's both tanks eliminated here for Laser Kittens to move forward and try to put some pressure down onto Lynxer. They find that kill, and that's going to be a nice defense here before this first payload checkpoint here on King's Row, as Laser Kittens battling back into this one, trying to contest with that combination of that Graviton Surge Dragon Strike that has been pretty lethal here so far for Dignitas.
Yeah, and that last engagement, Kib was able to get into the back line with that Nano Blade and really baited out the Earthshatter coming out from what, 7? But unfortunately, he whiffed. And then from there, because he was turned around, Winghaven came in, got a free one. Now Nesh with a great setup. And that's a 4-man Graviton Surge. But the Sound Barrier does come out on the side of Dignitas. Nano Boost onto what, 7 as he pushes forward. It's going to be Evoke that gets the first kill. Here comes the Graviton. Lands onto Spazzo and Gray. There's the follow-up damage. Dignitas cleaning up. It's all down to Kib and Krems. Try and keep this alive. But it's 6v4. It's pretty hard to fight. Payload is going to go ahead and make it into the checkpoint with a better time than Laserkins had. Now they're gonna have 3 minutes and 30 seconds on the side of Dignitas just to try and get it 65 more meters in.
Yeah, we are gonna be looking for Linkster to try to get some picks here. He hasn't been super consistent on the Hanzo so far, but the main point here is to try to get that ult as soon as possible. So we will see him trying to get that charge up, and of course Bromas using his in the last fight is gonna be trying to battle that one back into play as well. But now it's really going to come down to these Reinhardts trying to make a play. Winghaven with an opportunity. Kib going to pull out the Dragon Blade. Already into the backline looking for a kill on Toxican. But they're going to be able to find that kill. And it's Linkster actually coming up with that pick. And now he's got the Dragon Strike with a great opportunity to pull that out. Even without the Dragon Strike at all. Or they should be able to push forward. And again, they definitely want Bromas to get some of these kills to try to get that Graviton going for this potentially last fight here.
Linkster really coming alive on the Archer now. That's 3 kills going his way. Now we do have that tactical visor getting popped by Krems. He wasn't in the primest of positions and no one's able to get onto the point. That's going to be Dignitas getting King's Row here up against Laserkins, and they did it in really great fashion. They still had 2 minutes and 30 seconds towards the end of the map.
A lot of time to work with, and that was off of that Hanzo throughout the entire game. It was just a steady pace. We didn't really...
Yeah, we're going to be starting off on the garden portion of Lijiang Tower, so maybe we'll be seeing some pharmacies coming out, but I think they might just stick with a death ball style composition on both ends here. It looked like Linkster was hovering over the far for a moment, but thought better of it, and we'll be swapping off. So it looks like it's going to be that dive composition. It's going to be a 2-2-2 dive with a Reinhardt coming out on the side of Dignitas. Now on the side of Laserkins, Krems is actually hovering on the far right now. And it's not too surprising to see, especially here on the garden.
I'm wondering if Toxican is actually going to be pulling out a Pharah of his own here, because obviously he's not going to be staying on that Reinhardt. But the question is going to be what's going to pull out. And I think, okay, he actually is going to pull out the Soldier here. And they're going to be going for a very traditional dive composition here on the side of Dignitas, whereas Kib is going to be pulling out the Pharah as opposed to the Genji that we see on the side of Dignitas. But now we will see him trying to look for a kill onto the Toxican. Almost pushes him off, but not quite. What, 7 jumping in here. Barriers down for both Winstons. And now it's just going to be Krems dying off soon. But what, 7 actually taken down as well, and that's the tank, but... It seems as the Laser Kittens shouldn't be able to battle back into this one. Dignitas might be able to clean this one up here.
Yep, Dignitas just gaining the initiative there on the team fight. When Watt7 jumped in, he really like cut off both supports. They did not have anywhere to try and retreat from as they were pushed toward the house there. And so they were just kind of stuck out in the middle of nowhere, allowing Linkster to jump on into the back line with the help of Watt7 to finish them off. From there, they just won that team fight pretty much handedly. Now they are jumping in on the side of Laserkins, but Winghaven immediately going down. That's 2 kills going in favor of Dignitas. Now they're holding them at the bridge. Looks like we are finally going to have a reply coming out from Kib, as he was able to knock off What7. Still not quite enough. That's an easy team fight win for Dignitas. They've already got 25% on the board.
I mean, the only kill that they've been able to get so far is onto What7, and still getting a kill onto the Winston doesn't mean a whole lot, because as you can see here, he's already back onto the point. I mean, Winston is very good on this point, given the fact that it's just linear and open, that he can just go for one leap out of the spawn, and with a little help from Lucio, he's back in. And I don't like this play from Winghaven again, the third time. He's just rushed in by himself and just been taken out. Second time in a row that he was the first kill almost instantaneously, and it's going to be, again, just an easy fight here for Dignitas to pull through and just make easy, easy plays, clean everything up. And again, I mean, Laser Kittens really not executing well here so far.
Yeah, we also have to remember that the boop changes came in for Lucio, and so you can really push someone far back. But the more troubling thing is that when Winghaven does jump in, Team Dignitas are just really good at focusing him down immediately. Now we do have Toxian pushing forward with that tactical visor. It's the nano visor. The sound barrier is committed on the side of Dignitas, but they've already won this team fight pretty handedly. Now on the side of Laserkittens, they've got four ultimates to work with. So Winghaven, he's got that primal rage, hasn't been able to do much with it. Now Krems shooting what 7 out of the skies. They got the man advantage as they start pushing forward. 94%. Winghaven will be able to get onto the point now to try and get that overtime ticking as my
actually. And now Kib actually going to be going with the barrage, but he's not going to find anything. And they had that man advantage, but it's not actually going to work. And man, it is going to be somehow Laserkittens battling back into this game here. Winghaven now coming alive, and they do have an option here to flip this point, but they need to deal with Linkstar on the point, and that's going to be Bromas coming in as well. He does have that Pulse Bomb looking for an opportunity to clean up, but Nesh finds that kill and the flip along with it. And we do see Laserkittens now finally with the point on the board here.
I'll be in just a moment. I don't know why my game crashed. This is the second time this actually happened in the last 24 hours, but it's not too bad. I'll be right back.
And we will see here Nesh with the Pulse Bomb, and I'll be your solo entertainer for a little bit until Jameson comes back. But obviously we do see Nesh looking for an opportunity with the Pulse Bomb. Does get a stick onto Vayless and finds that kill as Nesh taken down pretty low here. No recall as he used it to get away from his own Pulse Bomb. So now we might see Dignitas jumping back on. Primal Rage ready for what 7, but he's not going to be able to pull it out. He actually gets killed off by Kib. And Kib on the point right now looking to clean things up. Finds the kill on Bromas, and now they're up to 40% here. And we do see him up, again, pretty high on this ult charge, looking for an opportunity to Dragon Blade. And what's happening coming back in? And it's going to be competing Dragon Blades here more than likely if Kib can survive the onslaught from Linkser. And they don't have the Nano Boost. Obviously, they would like to have that for this combination to work very effectively as they want to get a clean wipe up through here. And it is going to be opening up pretty soon.
Vayless is getting closer and closer. They're going to go ahead and use that Dragon Blade along with that Sound Barrier. Lynx are getting that first kill onto Winghaven. And now three members already down on the side of Laserkittens. They're just getting cleaned up. That was just the power advantage as Kib's trying to keep this alive with his own Dragon Blade, but he's getting battered around by that monkey. And now they're cleaning up. These are the final members. We do have Winghaven. He's going to go ahead and use his own Primal Rage to jump back onto the point. But still, Nesh going down a Toxican there. Now things are looking real bad for Laserkittens as they're just funneling onto this point one by one. Now the point hasn't been flipped quite yet, but now it has. It's in overtime as Kib is able to jump back on, but he already had to use his deflect and he's gonna go down, and that's gonna be overtime getting ticked one more time. But Winghaven able to stumble right on back in there. Does go down to what, 7. Now overtime still ticking down. Spazzo trying his hand at keeping it alive. Gray even swapping off to the Sombra, but yeah, one by one, they staggered in, they got cleaned up, and that's going to be Dignitas taking the first point.
But still, I mean, that was a lot closer in the scoreline than what we actually saw happening in the game. I mean, on the side of Dignitas, I think it looked a lot cleaner than what we saw in the scoreline. I mean, it was certainly, given the fact that we saw a nice stagger coming in, they did get a lot more score, especially on the side of Winghaven. But look at Toxican just playing in some push-ups for us, man. But nonetheless, going into this next map, Night Market here, it is going to be, I mean, this, we have to remember, this is Laserkittens' map here. They were able to take a round against Misfits, or they were able to take this whole map against Misfits, actually, and now Dignitas actually pretty cleanly taking it against them, and they're already up 1-0, we have to remember. So if Dignitas actually wins out here on Lijiang Tower, that'll be it. That'll be Laserkittens actually going home and going to Korea, as they talked about a couple days ago, actually, with a pretty disappointing loss, I would say, here in the first round of the loser's bracket.
All right, triple DPS dive composition coming out from both sides. On the side of Dignitas, they do have Vayless picking up the Zenyatta, but already things going in favor of Laserkittens as they have largely cleaned up the entirety of Dig. They're going to be able to get the point first this time.
But Kib making a couple nice plays, actually, and that secured the point for them, and he's looking to go ahead and contest this Soldier again. Should be able to find this kill, actually, but he's going to be forced to back off as that healing field came down, and Toxican going to be able to make his exit. And he's going to be getting back into position. Vayless looking for some opportunities here to try to get some spacing from the rest of his team. but we will more than likely see some aggression coming out. As we know, Kib and Winghaven love getting up in Vainless's face, and he's got no support here until finally Toxican makes his move. They do find that kill, and that's a nice pick. They're still pretty low, though, so this could definitely still go in any way. Lynx are finding a couple kills, though, primarily onto Gray, so that's the pillar tank and the pillar healer now taken out, and a nice boop coming out, actually.
Did you see Evoke that entire time? He was just in the middle of three DPS, no problem whatsoever. Lucio just has so much sustainability, survivability now, and also just being able to 1v1 people again as Dignitas have flipped the point now, and now they're starting to clean up. They're going to go ahead and reset Laserkins here. They're going to be respawning in. Kib has that Dragon Blade at the ready. Not quite that nano boost yet, though, but all three offensive heroes on the side of Laserkin, they have their ultimate, so it's a huge power spike for them, but things are starting to come online on the side of Dignitas.
And Broma's looking to try to get a little bit more damage in if possible so that he can get his pulse bomb, because they really want that pick going into this next fight. Gray already going to find a kill, though, as Kib pulls out the Dragon Blade, not going to get the nano boost as Gray didn't have it ready quite yet, but then he gets it out late. Gray going to fall, though, and already Dignitas have found kills despite the fact that we do see two ultimates used from Laser Kittens to make it three now as they're jumping onto the point. Nesh found a kill, so I think they want to try to pull that momentum into their favor. What Winghaven finding a kill in the Primal Rage, backing everybody off the point. They should be able to flip this one here, but man, did they have to use a lot and battle hard for that one to get that flip, and we might actually see everybody just pulling onto the point. We do see another ultimate utilized here as Spazzo actually going to be utilizing that sound barrier, and that's going to force Vainless to pull out the Transcendence. And again, ultimates from both sides all over the place as Toxican finds the Tac Visor, is going to get eliminated pretty easily there actually by Kib, and they're jumping onto the point. However, in the meantime, Dignitas just stealing away 3 points as they're just jumping on and off the point, trying to make sure that they secure this one, and it will eventually look like we will see Kib making these plays, but he's going to back off yet again, and Lynxer with a nice kill on Nesh might actually have secured this for the time being. Dragonblade coming out from Kib, though.
Man, this is Kib's second Dragon Blade coming on out in the last minute and a half now. He does try to jump on top of Toxican, but it's going to be Winghaven that cleans that off. Watt7 just trying to go ahead and force him back. Soundberry coming out once again. It's going to be Evoke this time. Bromas does get that kill onto Gray, and now might have swung things in favor. But as I say that, Kib's starting to come in with those resets. And at this point, I think, Diggy, just go ahead and give it up, as you've already got 99% on the board there. So super extended teamfight coming out, even a final deflect kill coming up from Kib there, but now it's coming down to the wire for Laserkins. They're at 50% right now, but they can't lose a single team fight.
Yeah, I mean, that fight just took so long for them to actually secure that. Dignitas got the 99%, Jamerson, that's insane. But nonetheless, they still have a couple of options. Winghaven did a lot with his Primal Rage the last time we saw him pull it out, so maybe he can do much the same here, already getting some pressure onto the Lucio. But it's going to be Lynxer pulling out the Dragon Blade of his own, looking for some kills. They already found two. They might be able to find Spazzo. He's pretty low here, but so is Lynxer, as he doesn't have any healing quite yet. And we will see Kib and Nesh coming through with a ton of kills. Dragonblade going to be ready again for Kib very, very shortly, as he's looking to just finish these guys out. And it's still back and forth. Both teams very, very close in terms of the competition here, trying to finish these fights out. But it's Kib once again coming through for his team here. And Lizard Kittens look like they're going to be able to close that one out, at least for now. And we'll have to see if anybody can get overtime started. And that actually is going to work out. And we will see, again, the nano boost onto Kib without the Dragon Blade. They still find the kill onto Wet7, and that should be overtime ticking out. We will more than likely see Dignitas trying to go ahead and keep triggering this overtime, but it should be Laser Kittens pulling away with this one.
Yeah, Kib really coming alive. Now the Transcendence is getting popped, but we've already got four members down on the side of Dignitas. It looks like it's just going to be Laser Kittens completing this out here. Real back and forth affair, and really came down to the wire, but they're going to go ahead and tie it up 1-1 as we move on to the control tower for our third point between Laserkins and Dignitas here on Legion Towers.
Really, really strong performance from Kib so far, at least in that particular map. And now moving on to the third, we'll have to see if he can continue that performance here, because Laserkins absolutely need it. They were very, very close to losing out on that one, but now battling back and showing good form again on the King of the Hill map here of Lijiang Tower. But Jamerson now moving into this third map, obviously, we are curious to see if there's anything going to be changing up, and I don't think we will see anything crazy happen here.
Are you sure?
I don't think Gray is going to stick to this.
I think he is. They pulled it out before. That solo heal composition with the Sombra just controlling all the health packs. And he has actually left the point here. So no Ana. It's just going to be Spazzo down to try and heal everyone up along with those hacked health packs. Now the dive comes on out. Wing Haven jumping right on top of Bayless. He goes down, but Gray has fallen himself. So it's now a 5v5 fight as Lichter is starting to clean up. Spazzo going down along with Nash. Dashreath that's coming on in. Mostly just going to be Dignitas winning out this team fight as Linkster just going ham in the back line there.
The problem is that maybe this would have worked before, but there's no way it's going to work now. I mean, Lucio just doesn't have the range to be able to get the healing on everybody unless you play a death ball, which isn't going to work because you have the soldier. He's going to be in the back line looking for some space. That composition just doesn't work. It doesn't make any sense why they even pulled it out at all, but we will see Gray actually making the swap, going back over to the Ana, and again, this does make a lot more sense. I do think that they're going to be able to compete a lot more with this particular composition. And now moving on, they have to deal with Baneless here, but already some aggression coming out from Wet7 and Winghaven pretty low as well with a Discord on him, so it should be Dignitas once again pulling out this fight as Toxican deals with Winghaven, and that's going to be pretty much all that they have to do there as Dignitas once again establishing dominance here in the early stages of this map.
Yeah, one of the things I'm really seeing coming out from Dignitas right now is the way that they're playing around the Lucio. If you've seen Evoke so far in the last 3 points, he's been playing really aggressively on that Lucio. So when the dive came out on the side of Dignitas and they jumped right on top of Gray, Lucio, Evoke was right in the thick of things there. And so that might be a point of weakness if they can try and take advantage of it, but it's going to be pretty difficult as Linkster's already gotten 2 kills with that Dragonblade on out. 62% on the board for Dignitas, and they are just steamrolling through Laserkins right now.
They are making it look so easy, but obviously they had a lot of momentum carrying through as we did see Gray swapping late off of that Sombra, and they've just, again, been kind of snowballing off of that first fight with that kind of weird composition that came out from Laser Kittens, which really doesn't work with this Lucio change, I don't think. And we will see, unless they want to change how they operate completely, and I think you'd have to change the soldier as well, unless he just goes completely self-reliant. But look at Wet7 just jumping in. Gray going to be taken down pretty low, and oh, somehow barely stays alive against Linkster. And we do see Krims as well, pulling out that Tac Visor with the Nano Boost as well, looking for some kills. Kib pulling out the Dragon Blade, and they're going to be throwing out a ton of options here of their ultimates, and that's not going to be good for the next fight, as obviously they have to win everyone after. They should be able to clean this one up here, Jamerson, but it's going to be a problem as they utilize a lot to be able to secure this fight here. They're really only going to have Winghaven with the Primal Rage and Nesh with that Sticky that they're going to be looking for the Pulse Bomb picks. And if Nesh doesn't find that, they're going to be in a little bit of trouble as Vainless has managed to get himself up that Transcendence, and they're going to be combating Toxican and Linkster in this next fight here with 2 offensive ults and looking to clean this one up.
You are definitely correct there, Hurix. Now they do have that Pulse Bomb coming out from Bromont. Doesn't quite connect, and now we do have that Tactical Visor getting used by Toxin. He hasn't found anything quite yet, but it's going to be Linkster. 1/Dash reset is able to complete the kills onto Spazzo and Gray, and Dignitas now forcing the rest back. Winghaven even tried to use that Primal Rage, but it's not going to be enough. Kib jumps on out. Point's going to get flipped. He does pick up that Mega Health Pack, but as he tries to jump back in, he gets focused down immediately, and now Dignitas here on match point.
This is definitely looking like Dignitas's map. I mean, they are very, very confident on this one, and we saw Kib trying to get back onto that point, and that was actually Evoke pushing him back, and then some nice little bit of damage coming out there from Toxican to be able to close that one. But now moving on to the Night Market, this is the map actually that we saw Laser Kittens taking, although we have to remember it was incredibly close. They had to battle for it, and it took them forever to actually secure the point in their favor off of that second fight. So we'll have to see maybe if Dignitas gets some early control, if they're going to be able to hold out a little bit better or get a retake in the latter stages if they do end up losing, because that's been pretty much the story of the game so far, is that they've been able to get control pretty early on, and then it basically just goes very much in favor of them going forward. But we do see typically Laser Kittens able to establish control at around 60% or so, and then it's just a retake from Dignitas to be able to close the map out.
Yeah, double hit scan actually coming out on the side of Laser Kittens here, as the Soldier 76 is going to get get picked up by Kib, and Nesh will this time be on that McCree. Bromas in the back line trying his best to try and split everyone up with this real death ball-y style, playing around the small health pack in the back as What7 is the first to go down. Bromas does answer on back, taking out Winghaven. So now it's a 5v5 fight as the point is starting to get ticked up on the side of Dignitas. Now I evoke with a grave boop onto Gray, but Spazzo answers in kind. Still kills going back and forth as Bromas and Nesh both go down. But the point is still in favor of Dignitas right now. It's still ticking up, but Kib getting that kill onto Linkster might have just swayed things just a little bit. What7 on this on the monkey is trying to keep this alive as he is able to slowly whittle down Winghaven, but they are finally going to be able to clean them up. And now it's Laserkin starting to answer back. They will flip the point. Baneless and Bromas on here now. Pulse Bomb does come out, but Krebs is going to eat that up with that projected barrier. And now the defense, or excuse me, Laserkins, they are going to be able to maintain control here and get this reset. And great timing coming up from them. They've got that sound barrier to work with. They've also got the tactical visor. Now Krems is also working very close towards that Graviton Surge.
But Vainless should be able to answer that Graviton Surge with that Transcendence as long as he doesn't pull it out too early. And we do see tact visors coming out from both sides. Tank falling very quickly. Actually, from both sides as well, but it is going to be Laser Kittens taking the most advantage of that as they find a couple of kills. Vainless should be dealt with. It is looking like we are seeing Dignitas running over to the point, trying to make a flip, but that's not going to happen as the firepower here from Laser Kittens, especially with Nesh sliding over as well and forcing the rest of Dignitas back, is going to be able to find the. They are going to be able to find those kills and keep the point secured in their favor. Now we are going to be seeing the Graviton finally coming out and both Zenyattas with that Transcendence option in the next fight here, but I do believe that Krems is really going to be able to find a nice Graviton. We'll have to see if they bunch up.
Yeah, but they do have the Transcendence. There's no Ana on either side. We do have that swap off. Toxican did swap off. Now the charge wasn't enough burst damage, but Winghaven swinging on Linkster. That's going to be a one-for-one trade as Gray does go down, coming up that Transcendence. Now Bromas with the second kill, taking out Krems here. It's real back-and-forth affair, but it's going to go in favor of Dignitas at this point as Nesh does fall. Now Spazzo just going to go ahead and reset with his team. Kib there, though, does get delayed just a little bit.
What7 actually staying alive there meant a lot for them because then they were able to just continue the pressure and just hold control on the point. They were able to get an early flip before actually even finding that last kill. And Gray going to be taken out pretty quickly there. Linkster makes, or actually winds up trading his own life, but killing Gray off I think is very good for them because now Vainless is going to be able to get ahead in the ult charge with Transcendence, and that's going to be very impactful. And Linkster should be able to make a clean re-entry into this fight. So I actually do like that trade for them going into this next fight here, Jamerson.
Tactical Visor is committed by Kib, and immediately Evoke answers in kind with that Sound Barrier. They are immediately just going to go ahead and fizzle that ult. Nesh is going to force that mech out from Toxican, though, and Gray finishes up with some great orbs of destruction there. Now, What7 jumping into the backline. Winghaven tries to go for the charge, but it's not going to be enough. Sound Barrier coming out on the side of Laserkins, and Bromas only gets that one kill onto Nesh there. It was a one-for-one trade. But now Laserkin's finally cleaning up, and it's going to be about 81% before it gets flipped. It's coming down to the wire here. This might be the final team fight.
We'll see that Graviton coming up as well here, Jamerson. I'm definitely looking to see if Krems is able to find some value inside of that one. They were able to find a nice pick inside of the Graviton last time, but that was all. So obviously we want to see some better execution from Laser Kittens if they want to be able to battle back into this one and send us to a game three. And we do see Toxican on the D.Va right now, just trying to take away some of this damage. Is he going to be able to eat up this Graviton? Krems looking for an opportunity to drop this one down. Has 100 energy, is looking for an opportunity to drop it, but it doesn't look like they're actually going to even need it quite yet, as Toxican is going to be dropping out of that mech, and now Transcendence coming out.
Graviton Surge does come out, but Daneless was bought just enough time to be able to get that Transcendence. Winghaven, though, with the Earth Shatter, cleaning up two. Now it's down to Bromas. He is going to be able to get that kill into Winghaven as What7 does get back onto the point here. Kib staying alive for now. He's got that projected barrier, but Krems now starting to really dish out damage on this Zarya. It's going to be a one-for-one trade, but Krems will be able to secure it for Laserkittens, keeping the series alive. We're going to map number 5 here on Lijiang.
It's been pretty rough here for Laser Kittens, though, but, you know, Krems definitely making the plays. Last time we saw Kib coming through and able to secure that for the team, and this time it was certainly largely from Krems that they were able to secure that. But this is actually one of the better maps, actually, for Dignitas going onto this one here, and we're going to be looking to see if maybe Laser Kittens can try to switch things up a little bit and maybe turn things back around. I do think that the double hit scan is working out for them a little bit, but I think mostly it was just Krims' performance in the last one that actually was able to secure that game for them. And maybe, you know, the fact that they have so many different options, so many different weapons that Dignitas has to deal with, Krims really has a lot of room to work with, perhaps, and we'll have to see if maybe Dignitas want to avert some of their tension towards Krims, or if they're able to execute a little bit more efficiently and maybe clean up quicker so that they can deal with Krims after a little bit more swiftly.
Dignitas sticking to this dive composition, but Nesh with a great flashbang there, catching them all out. He's already got two kills, and now they're starting to clean up. Evoke should be the next one to go down. Never mind, it's actually Baneless as Kib on that Soldier 76, not to be outdone by Nesh, his DPS counterpart.
Laser Kittens establishing control early on is very good for them, and I think that was actually a little bit of an overextension from what 7. I don't like the way that they actually engaged that. They put a little bit too much trying to deal with Vainless, who pulled back, had the Discord up, and the rest of the team just folded onto him because nobody followed in with what 7 initially. And now Broma's getting down. Oh, actually going to be taken out by Kib. Now they're going to have a 6v5 advantage, and they already have the advantage of being on the point first. What 7 going to drop there as well? And this is going to be an easy, easy fight here for Laser Kittens as Kib really coming alive here on the Soldier.
Yeah, I'm surprised that they actually committed onto that dive, especially with Bromas immediately getting taken out there. Winghaven just doing a solid job as the foundation solo tank, or excuse me, not solo tank, but as the primary tank on the side of Laserkins there. He's been finding some great charges along with some fantastic fire strikes. So you see he's already at 71%. Now, those huge CC ultimates starting to come online on the side of Laserkins here. They're going to have to be really careful as they try to dive in. Dragonblade does come out, but Sound Barrier immediately answered in kind by Spazzo. Three kills already going over for Laserkins. They want to take this to map number 3.
Man, they're definitely... This is looking like a totally different Laser Kittens. They're just battling into this one. We saw a nice flash from Nesh there, shutting down the Dragonblade. That happened right at the same time as the Sound Bear. Really, really solid answers from Laser Kittens so far to deal with some of these weapons from Dignitas, and now forcing Linxer off of the Genji for the first time so far, and now going over to the Roadhog. He's going to be looking to try to make some pick plays with that hook, and now they're going back onto the point, and this could very well be the last possible fight. And we do see, the Pulse Bomb actually forcing Transcendence out pretty early here.
But a huge Earth Shatter comes out from Winghaven. He's going to follow it up on himself. That's 4 kills, 5 already going over to Laserkins. And 91%, I don't think they're going to actually have the opportunity to try and contest at 95, 96. Now it is going to be Laserkins taking this to a map number 3 as they clean up the final remaining members of Dignitas.
Really, really nice performances from Laserkittens on both Night Market maps and then that last one as well.
Lower brackets in the European play right now. And lots starting to come on to become on the line. Remember, it is double elimination, so the loser of this will be knocked out of the tournament, and the winner moving on, like Hurix had mentioned, to face off against NIP. So just it's going to be a continual uphill struggle at this point.
Definitely going up into their next matchup, it's going to be tough for either of these teams. I definitely think Ninjas in Pajamas is a pretty decent team. I think they've gotten the kind of short end of the stick so far in their matchups, and we're waiting to see them actually just come out and really have a much better performance than what has happened so far. But we'll have to see as things progress. Route 66 is going to be the map that decides who actually is going to be contesting Ninjas in Pajamas later today. Again, we have 4 matches actually coming your way today, guys. So a lot of Overwatch action. And then on top of that, we also have NA coming through as well. 3 matches there. So 7 matchups today from the Overwatch pit side of things here. Definitely a lot to look forward to. But nonetheless, 30 seconds away from starting off the map that will decide who stays and who goes home here.
All right, looking at the defense coming out from Dignitas, they are going to be running triple tank. Bromas is going to be the solo DPS there. But for the Meteor side of that composition, Toxkin on the Zarya. What 7, of course, picking up the Reinhardt, and Linxer is going to be on that Roadhog. Taking a look at the offensive end, though, as they start getting out of the gate, I don't think Spaz is going to be sticking with that. Just want to make sure there's no shenanigans going on inside that train cart, and so he will be swapping off to Lucio, and now it's just going to be a 2-2-2 composition, Nesh and Kib once again, the hit scan duo coming out for the side of Legionkins.
This is actually the exact same composition they used for those final two maps of Lijiang Tower. They are very dominant with it, but obviously this isn't the same kind of situation, and Lynx actually with a nice pull with the hook there coming out onto Nesh, shutting him down, and now they're going to be able to get aggressive here, forcing themselves onto Winghaven. He's backed up a little bit. Lynx are going to be taken down as well, though, and of course we will see him coming back from the spawn, and Evoke not going to be in a great position actually to try to get him the speed that he needs to be able to get back quickly. So they might be at a disadvantage for a little bit here while they're waiting for Lynxer to get back. And without that hook, without that mainstay at the front line to kind of support what seven a little bit and provide an extra threat at the front line, you know, they might be kind of coming out behind here. And actually, it's going to be Laserkittens taking advantage of that here as Nesh finds that opening kill on what seven.
Yeah, it looked like the call to back off was made coming out, but unfortunately, what seven just stuck around way too long. Now the hook does come out. Lynx are finally answering on back, but that's going to be a 4-for-1 trade. Gray coming alive with this Zenyatta. That's 3 kills going over for him. And you really got to be careful around this Orb of Discords and the Orbs of Destruction. They do so much damage in conjunction there. And now the payload's starting to get pushed forward, making its final bend, as I believe Laserkins will have another opportunity to try and defend here.
And they are going to be able to make that contest, looking for an opportunity to get in here. Toxican going to go ahead and establish high ground with the rest of this team, and they do actually pull out Nesh's Deadeye. He's looking for an opportunity, and Lynx are going to be able to eliminate him with ease with that nice right click coming out. Kram's going to fall as well, and this is Dainatos coming through with a nice re-entry onto the point, and they do manage to wipe them up pretty cleanly, and not really actually, I mean, they didn't use anything other than the nano boost to actually secure that, while we saw two different ultimates used for Laserkittens, and most importantly, it is going to be Krims's Graviton Surge that's going to be down at the moment. So Dignitas, not only do they battle back into this one, but they also give themselves a little bit of an advantage in terms of the ultimate economy, as Toxican going to be able to have a Graviton of his own in the next one.
Yeah, and so now we do see Laserkittens pushing up to the high ground, up the hills there, as everyone just wraps around Big Earls right now, and it's going to be at this point a transpose, like offensive defensive positioning coming out from both teams. Now the offense on top of Big Earls facing off against Dignitas on the other end there, but at this point the payload is rolling on back. They do have to commit soon, but they're trying to find a pick, buy a little bit more time. Winghaven getting closer and closer to his Earth Shatter, so tactical visor coming on now. Gray gets hooked in, but here comes the Graviton Surge whole hog combination. What seven with a huge Earth Shatter 2 following it all up. That's a lot of ultimates committed on the side of Dignitas here. There's still a minute left to work with. Now on the end for the opposing side, Gray does have that Transcendence to work with. Winghaven will have his Earth Shatter 2, but they're going to have a difficult time trying to force them out of the high ground position here.
Bayless had to get pretty aggressive there to land that Bida Grenade onto that the Graviton Surge. So he wound up dying out, and he's going to be coming back into this. He is back in position here. They do actually find him getting a lot of damage. And if he lands that Bidock Grenade right there, and he will actually get his Nano Boost ready. But the problem is that if he does wind up using this too early here onto Bromas, they could answer back Laserkittens with Gray's Transcendence. And Gray actually is getting pretty low, so they need to... Oh, he's going to be taken out! Perfect opportunity for this ult! And they might be able to clean this up here, Jamerson!
They might have just put a hold to them here. Winghaven tries with that Earth Shatter, unfortunately. Majority of the team already dead. Pretty hard to follow up when you're dead. And now it's coming down to the last 10 seconds. They're gonna have a difficult time as Gray is the one pushing forward with that Transcendence. He makes his way all the way around the bend. He's got 2 seconds left. He makes it onto point with the help of what seven's charge there. He does actually get the overtime, but no one else is actually gonna be able to make it there close. And so they're gonna put a stop to them real early on 72.32 meters. That's all Dignitas need here just to finish this out.
Really, really good position for Dignitas to close this one out, and Laserkittens had a couple opportunities there, but with Gray falling short and falling early, actually, in that fight, they did not have the ability to use that Transcendence, and because of the 6v5 advantage, as well as the fact that the only answer that they had to the TAC visor coming out was that Transcendence, it was just easy, easy cleanup there for Toxicant to make alongside Vainless, finding that Nano Boost to him as well. Really good plays there from Dignitas. All came off the back of that nice re-entry. They only lost one fight in that entire defensive side. So really, really solid hold coming out from Dignitas. And now, if they have anywhere close to the same performance, I mean, really, they only have to win 2 fights here, Jamerson. That's all they need. If they can win 2 fights, then this map is over, the series along with it, and we'll be sending Laserkittens home after what was a very, very thrilling Lijiang Tower. So I'm definitely hoping that Laser Kittens can come through on the defensive side and definitely put up a really solid defense, at least to, you know, give us a good showing here, because they looked a lot better on Lijiang Tower and now just kind of coming a little short here on Route 66.
Yeah, unfortunately, like you had mentioned, Hurix, that huge pickoff onto Gray, he had that transcendence at the ready that could have been the difference maker in that team fight, but as soon as he fell, so did the rest of the dominoes following. Now on the defensive end for the Laserkins, they are going to be picking up a very meaty composition, triple tank. It's going to be Krems on the Zarya, Kid picking up the Roadhog. Actually, Krems had just swapped off now, but Winghaven's going to, of course, be on that. Reinhardt and Nesh picking up the Tracer here. He's in position just trying to get some free damage off early on. Bromos, though, does have that Sonic Arrow, might spot him out.
So we actually did see Crimson Kib swapping. They wanted the Roadhog as opposed to the Zarya, and that's now switching over to the Selfless composition, so expect a lot of aggression coming out from this squad. If they get any kind of advantage, they will definitely try to take advantage of that. And now with what's 7 being taken out early, you will see them pushing forward here, trying to take some more kills, but actually they're going to be backing off a lot sooner than I would have anticipated, not finding any kills after the fact, which is a little surprising. Nonetheless, we will see both teams kind of just getting their ultimate charge up in the meantime, as it is just going to be kind of open season a little bit. Lynx here looking for a hook, not going to be able to find a pick though, as what7 again being pressed down pretty low, and he's going to be taken down again just to about 10%, finally getting some healing as Lynxer gets slept there and will be eliminated as well.
Yeah, great charge coming up from Winghaven here, and still Nesh is on top of this train, just getting some free damage off. He goes for the pulse bomb, it does whiff, but they're going to be able to back away on the side of Laserkins. Nesh regaining his position over here by the train cart. He is going to try and face off against Bromos. Bromos gets the stick, but Winghaven, oh, his shield goes down at the same time. He's not able to get healed up, and now they smell blood in the water. They are on the hunt. Earthshatter comes on out, connects on to Krims. He did receive that nano boost. He had the tactical visor out too, finally answering back, but now things are looking real bad for Laserkins here, as they do need to get the respawns in. They've only got 3 people here now. The payload is making the bend here, but man, high ground already getting challenged as Bromos is up top here with the help of Lynxer.
What they really want is Bromos to get that pulse bomb very quickly, but he's not going to be in a position to get that, as he's going to be kind of battling people who aren't going to give him that quick charge, not going to be able to find a Roadhog, as Kib actually wound up swapping over to that Genji. And now with ultimates coming out on the side of Laser Kittens and Kib making that swap, they're looking to try to turn this one back around. Kib coming alive once again. We saw him do a lot of great things on Lijiang Tower there on Night Market, and now he needs to have that same kind of performance to be able to battle back into this one. He's really the only one left on the point trying to get these health packs, and that's going to be him in a 3v1. Kib going to die out pretty soon. What7 somehow hanging on, and that is going to be Dignitas pushing through with 154 remaining, finding that first point and finding the series along with it.
Congratulations to Dignitas there. It could have been a completely different story. We saw that Graviton Surge come out. Winghaven charged out into the back line. He was actually just facing off against, I think it was What7 and Toxican there underneath inside the mineshaft. And if someone was just there to help him out, dish out a little bit more damage, it could have been a completely different story. But man, Dignitas just able to complete this out. They had an excellent defense here. Just really shut down Laserkins. I believe this might have been the final play. No.